The highly anticipated launch of Warzone Season 3 has arrived, but the destruction of Verdansk has also brought on some server issues as well. For weeks, Warzone players have been waiting with anticipation for the start of Season 3. With rumors flying regarding a possible Nuke event that would send the Verdansk map back to the 1980s, players counted the days until April 21st. Now, the day has come and Warzone Season 3 has, indeed, undergone a massive facelift thanks to the rumored Nuke event. Unfortunately, it seems the missile didn't just kill the zombies on Verdansk, but also the servers. Warzone, the Battle Royale companion to the incredibly popular Call of Duty series. Warzone Season 3 was announced recently to begin the integration with the latest installment of Call of Duty, Black Ops Cold War. This, in turn, led to many theories about how Season 2 would end, with leakers and other insiders whispering that it would end with a nuke destroying the map Verdansk. Over the final weeks of Season 2, zombies also began to invade Verdansk, with cryptic messages causing these rumors to grow even further. On the day of Season 2's end, players queued up to see if the nuke was indeed coming and if the resulting destruction would reshape Verdansk as had been rumored. Unfortunately, those who were online for the event have had a tough time seeing anything. Continue scrolling to keep reading, click the button below to start this article in quick view. Players who were online for the start of Season 3, which occurred at 3 PM Eastern Daylight Saving Time, began reporting server issues. These ranged from high ping to an inability to even join the queue to enter a game. Raven Software has announced that it would be investigating the server issues that accompanied Part 1 of the destruction of Verdansk event. The developer acknowledged the issues with long queue times and instances where the game would crash. Clearly, this is not the ideal start to Season 3 that the Warzone developers were hoping for. With an event with this much build-up and hype surrounding it, anything less than a near-perfect start was going to cause criticisms from around the internet. Of course, these server issues were unsurprising, as there were likely millions of players swarming the servers to participate in the event, but the lackluster rollout is certainly disappointing to many players. Luckily, Warzone will get the chance to redeem itself. The Warzone Nuke is a two-day event, so players who weren't able to experience the destruction of Verdansk due to these technical issues can still participate on the second day. Hopefully, Raven Software will be able to fix the server issues quickly so more Warzone players will be able to revel in the destruction of the beloved Verdansk map. Next, Warzone player scores the easiest win ever without leaving the plane. Source, Raven Software, Twitter email. Who Genshin Impact's new Inazuma Archon is.